Hello everyone, Jurassic Man here, and today I want to make a small little video on what I think they should do for Mattel's Jurassic World line and its future collector's edition, or their vintage line for Jurassic Park. What we've known so far, thanks to Jurassic Park Outposts, which I'll put a link in the description, mark my word. This time. And I just want to make a little video on what I think we should need. Now, I'm not going to use these figures as examples, like what this should be here or this should be there, but I just want to like point out like things that most Jurassic Park fans want and have little acknowledged that they do want it. So let's begin. So the first thing I want to talk about is that their figure line are going to be 3.75 inch. Now, if you don't know what that is that, as I got here, a human figure, the Dennis Nedry figure. And 3.75 inch, this guy's roughly 6'4 inches tall. So if anything, he should be like head on shoulder right here. As you can see, his head would be on the shoulder, and then there's the rest of the body down here. Now, when it comes to comparison, said like the Dilophosaurus, this is pretty huge for Dilophosaurus, but in fact, they're probably this big in the movie in real life. I'm still believing that that's a juvenile, and I guess most other people do. But with a human figure scaled down, this would be a bit more accurate to the one that killed him in the novel. Because if in the novel, he dies more horribly dead. So, that's what the figure line is going to be. I really wish they'd change it to 4 inch tall and not the other way around. And another example I want to point out are these. Well, first off, I want to point out that they should not have fixed position figures. Nobody likes the fixed position figures that most of these figures get. When it's in a fixed position, it's in a position like this, where it's not going to be moving at all. And with problems like that, when they try to dynamic or make it more likable, like, this could be good for a dynamic pose, but in play-wise, there's little imagination to it. And because they try to dynamic it, the figure would have a hard time standing, as its points of... The point where it needs to be for standing is balancing issue. It's a bit off here. It seems to be up more toward the torso and by the shoulders, which it should be by the legs. But because the tail is small and the weight is positioned as a U, it's just gonna fall unless you get it in the right balance or the rest curve. And also another thing, that their feet are also big to hold them like that, but flaws are flaws, and like that. The Spinosaurus is not a flaw, the Spinosaurus is a masterpiece. Oh, and yeah, the Spinosaurus, make another one, I guess, for the vintage line. If they are going to do one for Jurassic Park 3, they should make a new Spinosaurus. If the vintage line is going to be like a small scale, like, that's cool and all, but if it is going to be small scale, make a more accurate, positioning. I'm not saying this guy is inaccurate. He is pretty accurate, but only up to his head is accurate. The rest is not very, like the tail. The tails are larger compared to them. Another dinosaur I want is the Brachiosaurus. Now, I don't know how they're gonna do it, but the Brachiosaurus should be there. We should have a Brachiosaurus ever since the very beginning. We don't need to wait till Jurassic Park 3 for one. Maybe do a buildable figures, like what you do to most of your other figures. That seems to be very popular. Instead of a buildable human figure or vehicle or some mech they might have, but the stupid. They should have a dinosaur buildable figure. And the perfect one will be this one. And instead of putting it on the human figures, or maybe in the human figures as well. Maybe like the human figures will have the legs. Some dinosaurs will have the tail. One will have one half of the body. The other one will have the other half, and the last portion would be the two heads, or maybe like one single neck, or half the neck with the head, with one of them has the head. and something like that. Make a big figure, something worth getting, and don't like try to make it too big because you gotta make it in scale. If it was one of those 3-inch figures, it would probably be around this big, but that's a bit of a problem. I'm thinking that maybe not should be with the humans, but with the dinosaurs. And it doesn't have to be electronic, because if it is electronic, where would the batteries go? Maybe on the torso. And if somebody has a single torso, they could just constantly press the button or activity that it does need to order to electronic, and that would be very weird. Just imagine the torso just making that noise while the rest doesn't. Another thing is, and I'm bringing Nedry back, is we need accessories with them. The last human figure to have accessory was the Owen figure, which only had his gun and the flashlight, which is pretty dumb. But what we do need is like a human figure with some kind of weapon with them, and a hatchling. We need to bring hatchlings back, if it is going to be in the vintage line or not. The vintage line may come first, so once they see the success on the vintage line, then that's what they'll be doing for the rest of the line. And that'll be great too. Maybe diverge the hatchling, maybe even have hatchling of the hybrids you're having, like the now named Indoraptor, which is a pretty good name I'm growing to. Another dinosaur to have, and obviously, is the Dilophosaurus. Again, we've always had the Dilophosaurus in every toy line movie, but only it appeared in 2 movies and only briefly seen in the second movie as a picture, I think. But that's about it. We need another Dilophosaurus to diverse. Not in the toy, but in the movie itself, because I'm tired of just having Dilophosaurus. You made this iconic, and you're not going to use it again. That's pretty dumb in my book. Another thing. Scaled Triceratops. I am annoyed that we never got a big Triceratops anymore. It's always the same thing. A small Triceratops and an even smaller Triceratops comparison to the rest of the dinosaur line. Then we got the Stegoceratops, which didn't help. 2 of my favorite dinosaurs into 1 dinosaur, which seems kind of weird. They should have used Nosutoceratops as they inspired the head for. Look that up, Nosutoceratops, and you'll see where the head comes from. It's more inspired than that than the other. But we need a big Triceratops, like in the first Kenner movie. And if Triceratops is going to be there, which it is, along with Stegosaurus, we kind of want figures for those two as well. I really don't like it when they have new dinosaurs and yet don't add them. Also, if Gallimimus is going to be there or not, you could still make a figure for it. The Gallimimus is another iconic dinosaur from the Jurassic Park franchise, which didn't appear until The Lost World, and then skip Jurassic Park 3, and then back to Jurassic World. And that's what we also need too. We also need more Hadrosaurs, as we only had 1 in the entire line, and 1 hatchling or 2 hatchlings. So yeah, maybe more Hadrosaurs as well. Those are the stock animals, as you can say, the cattle, the Cretaceous, and we need those too. And maybe a Camarasaurus figure or something else to fit in the spot for the Brachiosaurus. Another dino we need, or not dinosaur, accessory we need is that, well, of course, we need a Velociraptor, 1 in a neutral pulse too, but we also need capture gear for them. Capture gear is, I'm not really a big fan of capture gear, but we do know that some of the Jurassic Park fans like capture gear, and especially those completionists that when they find vintage toys and want to complete the whole accessory. Of course, I don't know if this is the first one that came in the Wave 1 or Wave 2, this is also separate. But is an example that we do need some capture gear. It only appeared in like 4 lines, and then that's it. 5 lines, if you count. 6 lines, if you count for the JP Toys line, but that's not Kenner, that's Hasbro. Oh, and again, we need a neutral pose for the dinosaurs as well. Neutral pose gives more imagination. And how about test your mechanics first, because I'm not saying this was your thing, but mechanic-wise, it needs to actually function. And don't focus on mechanics too much, as we also want some accuracy. We don't want to end up like one of the dinosaurs that have a stubby tail. Another thing is, bring in the young Triceratops again, is dino damage. Only put him on the big dinosaurs, like the medium range large. Don't put him for the small dinosaurs. And don't be lazy like Hasbro and put permanent dino damage. Permanent dino damage is a bad thing. It looks like the dinosaur is already dead, but we don't want that to happen. Either do it like this, add an extra piece for it. Maybe some online thing where, like, if you lose it, you could call and order a new one for, like, $2 or so. Either do dino damage or don't do them at all. That's my wish. Well, most of the other wishes as well as the Jurassic Park group. And this is personally my favorite, since you guys are going to do a vintage line or even add it in the Jurassic World line or Jurassic World, all that such. Please, please, it is my only wish, and I'm still sure to scope this somewhere around, and Hasbro has given you the rights to it. Yes, this is a video for Kenner, but please bring the young T-Rex back. It's probably the best dinosaur figure in the whole line. How is it the best? Well, I'll make a video on that one day explaining why I think the young T-Rex is the best dinosaur in the whole line and the best toy in the whole Jurassic Park series. It only had 3 reprints and 2 re-releases, and all the others except the first release had capture gear, and they all had amazing paint job. Every single one, even that horribly ugly looking Hasbro one but with the oddly patterned design. But we need another young T-Rex, and we also need, like, just something small. You don't have to make all the dinosaurs, you know, like that. Also, in a neutral position as this, and I don't know how the rubber is. I recently found out that this is not like actual rubber, but polyester fiber, which is, well, fiber, actually. They just do it somehow with rubber, and we just need something like that. Like latex, I don't care, as long as it is not paper thin like the animatronic Spinosaurus. Not very fragile as those shown in the Stomp and the Strike and the early releases of the Indominus Rex, but a rubber that's so durable that the only way you could break it is if you actually tear it or bite it off, like some people. Heck, my babies or my baby nephew is already biting the tail. Luckily, it's not that damaged, but you know, I don't want to risk it. These guys are, and that's another thing, these guys are also very cool. I mean, who doesn't want this? Even if you don't have the big T-Rexes, you can still play around with the human figures, and that's all. And it even scales up nicely with any size human figures, as you can make it as a juvenile T-Rex, a baby T-Rex, or even those small figures as an adult T-Rex. And don't rely on like machines or anything like that. Rely on the rubber to make the action feature work. Again, I'll do a video on why I think the young T-Rex is the best Jurassic Park toy in history. So, I hope you watch this video, and I hope Mattel gets to see this video. I don't know if they will or not. They most likely will not. But I hope this goes around the system or something like that. And that's about it. I hope you guys like the video I make. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And tell me on what's your opinion on what do you think we should have for Jurassic Park line. I'm very interested. So I hope you guys liked this video. Again, sorry. And I'll see you guys next time. Oh, wait. One last thing. Sorry. One last thing. Don't screw this up, please. No screw holes. If we're gonna add screw holes, add it in the battery compartment. Okay, that's it. Goodbye.